Yeah, next in our Paradox Classic Game Marathon is March of the Eagles. That was basically the Hearts of Iron formula. Perhaps mixed a bit with some very bare bone Europa Universalis into a new game. Yeah, wasn't that perceived well, especially on release? As you can see, also the reviews are mixed. Some like it because of its straightforward and simple approach. And for others, it might be not enough because of its often considered bare bone mechanics. But I think still it holds up if you look for a simple Napoleonic strategy game. In real time, there might be not that many options, so we can check it out. Also, considering that the price you can acquire it is very low. Before we do that, even if you might be not happy with its simplicity, you might check out the mods. There's at least on ModDB and perhaps also on Paradox Plaza forums. Seems like some mods that are not too old. I had two in my view enhanced, which already has a release not that long ago, and a new version scheduled. When this will release, I mean, it is already over a year ago that this was posted. But yeah, there is a mod which will improve somewhat, I think, the map. And then we had here Conflict of the Eagles started 1 year ago, coming with some nice complex maps. It was mentioned it should release quite soon. It didn't, went silent. It's of course not the best sign, but you might find some mods. There's some. Also found a mod that is called the Great Northern War. But for this you need to log in on the Paradox Plaza. Some mods you can only access if you have an account. I currently can't show you that. But make a account or log into your account on Paradox Forum. Log in and check out this mod. Perhaps you will also find better mods, because usually this place is the first address you want to hit for Paradox mods. Okay, let's go into the game. Perhaps one thing I can show you is a manual, 108 pages, nice in color, a lot of pictures and some nice paintings. Doesn't look too bad. Sengoku, what was that again? Never played that, perhaps I want to check that out. That is some sort of Hearts of Iron Ghost Samurai. Comes to some Mod Manager. Yeah, we need to quickly restart. 40 hertz is unbearable. Why set up that low? But I was already wondering in my test play. Now I know why. Because the difference between 40 hertz refresh rate and 165, you will definitely notice. Watch me. Forget it. Yeah, we will run now full HD. Yeah, this is the engine basically from Crusader Kings 2, this Clausewitz engine. Which is, I guess, some sort of improved Hoy engine or whatever. Oh. Yeah, multiplayer, real-time, I guess. Not sure if there's some PBM option. Tutorial. It's one grand campaign, 1805. I think one big point was also that the campaign is too short. However, there are mods that improved that. Yeah. Something that... What I read in those, a lot of those negative reviews is that they consider the campaign too short. But there might be mods that expand it with proper events. You can basically pick the major powers. I think no minors you usually can pick by, exactly, by selecting the country itself. Yeah, you could also play minors. If you desire, so I could play entire Egypt, a minor, Persia, why not? And dominate, let's play Prussia, Preußen. Do those minors also have descriptions? Yeah, they have, okay. Everybody has descriptions. Your map doesn't look too bad, even by nowadays standards. I usually like to play in those simplified non-terrain maps, but sure, you should check what terrain you are in. Yeah, about the system, I can show you the interface. Battle system is somewhat similar, you can also notice perhaps from those like in Europa Universalis or Crusader Kings. Usually you have armies that come with left, right flank, center and some reserves, and units are split in those very basic types. Like light infantry, heavy infantry, cav, arty. I was always having the feeling as in Europa Universalis that the battle system could be more complex. As in Crusader Kings, there was always not real... I mean, in all Paradox games, basically, those battles, perhaps I need to check it out in Hearts of Iron 4, but... battle systems were rather always, at least I felt for me, a bit basic. Is he watching a bar going left or right? Yeah, but you can activate here some detail, and then you will also see that those units have even individual settings that at least offers here some considerations, tactical considerations. That's exactly what I'm talking about. Can set tactics. So you have some, it's not only sending counters into the battle, but some consideration you can do. Leadership. Yeah, as we know from other games, can pick then some guys that have different abilities. Yeah, but then you have the interface that is a diplomacy screen. You can contact countries and get stuff like declare war, coalition. This game will, I guess, also somewhat be driven towards the historical situation. France facing the coalition, but could also be that you might become allied with France and strive for world domination. So let's say we want to go into the coalition with the UK. Might be a bit too early. UK, I mean, with Britain. Great Britain. Our relation with France is too good. 5, must be 0 or lower. Yeah, then insult those French. Send them some nasty words like merde and whatever. Send an insult. You could do that, yeah, in order to screw them and then make the coalition more likely. Or you could befriend the French and then probably the coalition would work out different. So yeah, there's a diplomacy screen, then you have an overview over your empire, how much control you have, and there's some decisions you might know from games like Crusader Kings or EU4. Currently we have no decisions. Leadership. You see, it is very basic compared to a game like Europa Universalis. So if you look for something detailed, it definitely can't hold an inch with Europa Universalis, especially DLC'd out. Super DLC'd. And that is very basic, overview. Victory point, budget are so quite simple. Military, you can build stuff for simply for a cost of manpower and ducats. I have some basic modifiers. Yeah, ideas, that is basically research. Very simple. Yeah, not sure why diplomacy is also here, but it seems like I would expect something like an empire overview here, but it's okay. It's the same screen. So everywhere is this help? Exclamation mark. Yeah, it's not always a question mark. And yeah, you can also do a lot on the map, yeah, like you know from those other games. Yeah, by hitting a state, you can sometimes. Good, we are currently not at war with anybody, we are not even that problematic with the French. Yeah, Euro movement is straightforward, yeah. Simply right click like an Ahoy or in other Paradox games. Yeah, we have a lot of unemployed leaders. Those guys need money, of course. Yeah, this nobility. So let's fill our ranks with leaders. I think the most suitable one is always at top. What is my biggest army? This one here. Georg von Pirch, take over. Here, right flank. But let's first fill those main armies. I don't think that is really sorted. Ah, here. Defensive rating perhaps in the beginning. This is simply overall expertise. This overall expertise. That is an aggregated value, simply showing you how good somebody is in basically in every if you take all fields together. However, this value is not used for the game. Yeah, that's a nice one, so it shows you basically, but still, he might be having weak points. This guy is indeed good in everything. So small armies here, that is a big army. Yeah, that's of course also from a role-playing standpoint, yeah, five numbers. I mean, it is also many other Paradox games. I think always the military part is somewhat lacking, especially when it comes to portrayal of leadership and everything. I think that is also in, isn't that also in Europa Universalis that leaders only have three values or something? But yeah, I mean, depends on. Good. Is everybody now having a job? How many 4 unemployed leaders? They should work here in my personal. Ah, yes. Good. I mean, if almost all positions are occupied, we might keep 2 generals around. In order to, here, wait, left flank. In order to tell me jokes. We even have still some positions open, whatever, okay. It's fine. Good, yeah, and then you continue the game. I mean, right now not everything will explode immediately, yeah, because first the war needs to develop itself. But we could do basically something. We could, yeah, let's send an insult to France. Perhaps we can trigger a war quickly to show it to you. You are silly, gentlemen. What was it? War declared immediately. Ah, yeah, the Great Britain immediately invites me. Hey, I saw what you did here. You called those French silly. That was very ungentleman. Join the coalition. Yeah, Jimmy, joining. Okay. This will, I guess, piss the French even more off. Yeah, you have minus 44. From 0 to minus 44, yeah, immediately declare war and get wrecked by the French. Yeah. By calling them silly. Yeah, Jimmy, that is an enfant. That is an enfant here. Immediately mobilize. What is this here? Border troop. Yeah, you never know when those Austrians will stage a coup d'etat here against us. Better keep 1,000 guys around here in order to show those Austrians that we are taking it serious. Right, can we move here? Do we have some passage of. Oh, you guarantee our independence, Russia. Thank you. That is good. Wait, that means we are attacked by the French. The Russian will enter. Yeah, I guess that is even fine. Yeah. Great. Okay. Yeah. Perfect time to build universities. Should we tell me about those weapon factories? No, education is important, sure. Good. Can I invade here? Yeah, I first need to declare war to them. Can I cross them to. I said, you are silly. What? Call to arms. Now it's over. Yeah, I guess now the war will start. And we're probably at war. Yeah, you see, it is very straightforward. Yeah, this. Yeah, we are at war. They have 20,000. Rather form up here with something proper. Let's stack them. 1k should be enough to defend the Empire. I mean, I wonder how this game really turns out in this... I mean, the Napoleonic Wars were very complicated wars. It was not this frontline wars of World War II, especially. Napoleonic Wars were extremely different because warfare was back then different. It was not only war about territory, it was... I wonder how this works in this game. If they can keep this up a couple of years, or if this is decided rather fast. But that is always, I think depicting the Napoleonic Wars on a strategic level is quite a challenge. Jimmy, why are so slow? That is my city, Hanover. Oh, Hanover was independent, right? Great Britain controls it. Okay. Interesting. Get wrecked. Yeah, that's what I mean. It's basically stacking. That is sometimes what I in Paradox games don't like that much. Be it Crusader Kings, EU, or okay, Great Britain controls it, France is French, but only captured by Great Britain. Yeah, I mean, can... Okay, what's going on here? Naval blockade. I also want to participate. With my one transport Schwadron. Yeah, Preußen's fleet is nothing to write home about. Is that really the only ship we have? Ostseeflot. Okay. Impressive. Yeah, but I read one review was really good. He said that he loves the game because without this game he wouldn't have discovered other war games or grand strategy games, whatever you want to call them. Because it's so easy, it is accessible, yeah, you move stuff around. I mean, we also know, play quite fast. You need, of course, to watch out for those engagements. It's besieged. Do I need to press something? Ah, they're besieging, okay. The French even didn't leave a commander back. We want to assault, but assaulting those modern fortresses is suicide. Maybe we might pull it off with our huge army, but... And yeah, he mentioned that this game basically was straightforward, low learning curve, and opened them up for other games. So I think it is a good entry level grand strategy, or... I mean, all those Paradox games are basically... I know Europa Universalis, okay, that might be a bit, especially with a lot of DLCs or the newest Hearts of Iron. They might be already on medium or average level or whatever. Intermediate level. That's a good word. And yeah, check out those mods. Perhaps those mods make it more deep if you look for that. Doesn't look that good for the French. Yeah, that is what I wonder. Yeah? This war had, you see already the map back in the days was so complex and so many nations involved and... I mean, those wars were basically also, to some extent, world wars. World War One, World War Two, that is not really true. There were already a couple of world wars that might qualify for world wars beforehand. We are now allied with the Russians because we are receiving their troop movement via WhatsApp. I guess we are allied with them. Austria, not yet. We are already have the feeling that the French are... Ah, okay, I mean, now they're massing up some troops. I mean, this fortress there... Well, it seems like the Brits handle it. Yeah, this stack moving around, stacks everywhere, that was always in this engine there. What? I thought 403 guys, not 400, I was thinking 403k. Saxony pulling off some army of doom, suddenly. I mean, it's really important to take that fortress. I want to hear my Bremen back, sounds German. It's like might take ages. Ah, come on, let's move into France and have some fun here. Party's going on here. Let's join everybody else. Yeah, and what is good alternatives? Sure, you might check out Hearts of Iron. Europa Universalis. Perhaps there's even, I mean, it is also focusing on this period, not sure how detailed it is depicting it. Or if there are some mods or single scenarios that... Other than that, we recently showcased, I think, a board game from Matrix. And yeah, I might check out HODs. There's a Napoleonic Warfare game by HOD. But yeah, it's very difficult to pull off this war in a... even the John Tiller games, they focus basically on specific theaters and time frames. Yeah, Germany, Eastern Front, Western Front, that is pushing front line back. Sure, there's some changes, yeah, but this year was really armies battling each other. It was really different. Okay, I should give you an idea. I mean, you can get the game for a couple, for the price of a coffee, I guess, especially now when everything is on sale. And as you know, after a sale, as before the sale, you will definitely find ways to acquire this game for almost nothing. And yeah, it is a very straightforward Napoleonic era grand strategy game. It reminds me a bit of this Rome game, or this ancient game. which was also very bare bone when it released. I think now they released some DLCs for it. Imperator of Rome was also in the beginning quite bare bone. Not sure how, but at least it received some DLCs. But yeah, check out those mods if you look for more depth, or you might also look for a different game, even if there is not that many, that much that comes to my mind. It is difficult. Okay, now I will return with, let's see, Victoria 2. That is still considered to be a classic, and soon Victoria